Dear participants, welcome to our workshop. Today workshop is about PMP. Your trainer, Sir Atif, will conduct this session. Sir, please continue.
Okay, जी, अस्सलाम वालेकुम. मेरा नाम आतिफ अकरम है. I will just introduce myself. I have a total experience of 17 years. And I have worked in Siemens Dubai for 3 years in the construction of electrical substations. And then I moved to Saudi Arabia and worked on different projects of malls, high-rise buildings for 7 years. And in 2018, I came back to Pakistan due to some family compulsions. And I have joined Karachi Shipyard. And now I'm working as a, before we are, I'm working as a project manager. Now the this project is completed and now I'm working as a manager maintenance. In this project name is shiplift and transfer system. Okay, today I will give you a small briefing or can conduct a small discussion on the importance of project management. Okay, let's start. Basically, project management implies focus on applied skills, knowledge. When I'm talking about knowledge, it means how to handle scope, schedule, cost, resource procurement and communication and risk, and tools to see a project from conception to solution. Just delivering value to its customers or clients. Okay. First of all, I will tell you what is a project. It is converting a vision, dream, or a need to reality. It is an endeavor to bring something from dream into its practical solution or reality. So project has definitely a beginning and an end. It cannot be like operations to keep on producing things, but it has a definite starting and end date. And it has a specified outcome or requirements or scope. And the customer or client specify the quality and specifications of the product which is to be delivered or service which can be delivered. And he also mentioned the cost at the start of the project. What is the budget for this project? Project characteristics. As I told you, it has a definite start and beginning. It can produce a unique service or a product. When I'm talking about service, for example, now some countries are working on the COVID vaccination. Because they are doing some research and development work. Or for example, previously there are no hospitals related to cancer and brains, neurologists. Now, due to this upcoming this illnesses and these things, it has give a chance to develop some project. These are the basis for doing a project. Previously, we don't have Android phones. Now we are using Android phones and we are using laptops and latest mobile phones, latest technology for our communications. So these will generate the need of a project. What is management? Basically, management is a technique of understanding the problems, needs, and controlling the use of resources, cost, schedule, scope, and quality, and how to manage risks, and how to manage our objectives, which are aligned with the organization. Now I will discuss about project management. As I told you before, application of knowledge, skills, skills means soft skills. It can also include your interpersonal skills, tools and techniques, bringing other people.
बिल्कुल, आप skills share करके रखेंगे अपनी PPT की, आप introduction देंगी और introduction देने के बाद आप सर को foreign host बना देंगी. Recording आप सबसे पहले start करेंगी.
Application of knowledge, skills, tools and techniques to project activities in order to meet stakeholder needs and expectations from a project. Basically, needs are the things which are stated, which are mentioned or which are specified, clearly specified in your specs or in your contract. And expectations are which are unstated part of the project. Means what the company vision is or what the organization vision is, what they want to achieve from the project after 5 years, 10 years, or what is their ultimate goal or strategic goals. So basically, completion of a project within budget, on time, and without compromising on quality. This is our aim for the project management. The project management professional is a globally acknowledged professional certification that validates the professional's education and experience in project management. This coveted credential is offered to individuals who qualify in the PMP exam conducted by the Project Management Institute, which was started in 1969 and which have member of more than 600,000. In fact, project management is a gold standard for project management certification around the world. PMP can help you in opening new doors and advancing your career. It is a well-renowned and respected certification. According to many surveys and career websites, it is one of the top certifications in the world. PMP certification is an unbiased endorsement of your professional experience and project management knowledge at a global level. Having this certification under your belt exposes you to a great benefits and fringe benefits in your career development and growth. Now we will discuss about the scope of project management in professional life. It has an excellent scope. It is recognized in many countries or in many industries. Although it's a difficult exam and costs are on the higher side, but there are many advantages. It can be said without any doubt that project management professional can excel your career to new heights. Being a certified project management professional, certified is a proof of your skills required to initiate, plan, execute, monitor and control, and lastly, closing of the project. Importance of project management. Number one, proper project planning. With proper project planning, we can translate our plans into solutions. It includes how to deal with human resource, how to manage our resources, how to deal and adjust our schedule, cost, communication, and how to manage contracts, how to manage procurements. And secondly, essential leadership. Project management demonstrate essential leadership for the project managers. For example, I have talked about proper project planning. After planning, somebody must lead the project, and the leader who can inspire and motivate and guide the team to attain the objectives. So this project management certifications, first of all, we are doing a planning, and then it will inspire, how it will provide you tools and techniques which are globally recognized, how to deal with, how to manage our skills and knowledge. Number third, when I am talking about alignment and visibility. Often what I see, project managers bogged down into weeds of project work executing tasks needed to complete a product or a service. Proper project management allows everyone in the organization from top down to see the bigger picture or a true picture. It allows to understand organization's strategic goals and related projects to meet these goals and objectives. Number four, the importance of reduced risk. Often organizations set ambitious goals due to improper planning or some other reasons. Project management allows to identify risks, prepare plans, avoid risk, how we can avoid risks, how we can mitigate and prepare risk responses, plan in case of emerging risks. And number five, save money and minimizing cost. Definitely when we plan and execute our activities in a nice and in a proper way, we can save our lot of money and to achieve the project benefit, to attain towards the project benefits. Effective project management tracks all cost better by splitting work packages into activities or breaking down the work into smaller activities or tasks. And can project management helps to investigate less expensive ways or alternative means for doing the work in a more efficient and effective way. Lastly, improve communications at all levels. Most often we see that project activities are tied to other tasks and other activities which are dependent on other tasks that are being done by a different team member, supplier, or must be done prior to another task very soon to follow. Here, effective communication improves between stakeholders, team members, vendors. Importantly, communication can help me team members to up to date with current events and current status of the project and to keep other members updated how to achieve next steps and how to move forward. Now, I have already discussed about the importance of project management. Now I will mention the advantages of project management. It can increase your marketability and enhance career opportunities. A PMP certification can help to reach global organizations working in different parts of the world because it is globally recognized, well renowned. Instead of doing masters, I think we have to go for international certification. So you can accept your or excel your career opportunities around the globe. Communication. Number two, communication is key to successful project management. Project management professional certification signals that you can speak a common language and understand the project management framework, which is very essential for the group and good and proper communication. You can take on many different kinds of projects in your career. It is likely that you will have to work with different team members around the globe. If you can speak a common business language, you will ensure that everyone stays on the same page and there is no miscommunication. And there is, because our 90% of communication is through non-verbal clues. So when we deal with communication in an effective way, so everybody, every stakeholder, every vendor, every supplier knows what we are talking about, what we are explaining about, and how we can develop a consensus on our task, on the upcoming task or issues. project management enhance your latest knowledge of practices and techniques in management? For example, how we can do brainstorming, how we can do root cause analysis, how we resolve conflicts, how we can create facilitation among team members, and to develop a team charter. So how we can set the basic principles for our team, how they can deal with each other, with different cultures, with different people around the globe, around the world. It looks good in your resume and certifies that you know the project management, improves customer satisfaction and increase revenues for the company. Because once you are working in multinationals, it gives you a chance that you can correspond to all your neighbor countries or around the globe with different cultures, different peoples, with different backgrounds. Number six, it can help us in increase our self-confidence and improve professional satisfaction. Number seven, high earning potential. And most importantly, it validates to work for any industry of your preference, be it in IT, defense, government, engineering, medical, or government, like that. It upgrades your leadership qualities. Certification means that you are dedicated to improve your knowledge, skills, and credentials. This translates to respect from employers, your peers, team members, and clients. Now I will put some light. Why do companies use project management professionals? To handle projects effectively in an organization, because now in upcoming days, a company may ask for the pre-qualification documents or pre-qualified list of the vendor or suppliers, and they require that they have a requirement that the companies must have 10 PMP certified professionals with them, or 15, like that one. So it plan and assess the resource needs for the project. Once you have the project management knowledge, you can plan and assess resources according to the needs of the project and according to the requirements to meet the project objectives. It can help to estimate project cost and make proposals without gold plating. To plan and schedule activities in a project, it allows to allocate the right resources at the right time and to assess risk and failure points and make up backup plans how to deal with risk. It can lead a project team effectively and communicate well with the stakeholders. In project management, there are five process groups. Number one, initiating, planning, execution. Number four, monitoring and controlling. Definitely the monitoring and controlling is covering all the aspects. In an overall, it will cover the initiation, planning, execution, and closing as well. In initiating, the project is officially authorized and it specifies the business need, how to refine and filter the business needs. In initiating, sponsor selects the project manager and determines the authority for the project manager. Means how much the budget he can approve, how can he can play within the activities. So it helps to identify stakeholders, determine their influences, expectations and impact, and most importantly determines the high level requirements, objectives and constraints and assumptions for the project. In planning, project planning is extremely important both in real life and PMP exams. Planning process creates the plans for schedule, cost, procurement, risk that govern the project. In this process, the project manager and team perform detailed analysis how the objectives can be achieved, which are mentioned in the charter, and how we can maximize the business benefits and how it can be achieved. In planning, we also expand and refine the assumptions and constraints, like related to schedule, resource and cost from project initiation, so that they are more specific and detailed. So first of all, we have seen initiation, then we move towards planning. Now we are moving towards the execution. In the execution process, we will execute our plans and produce the work or deliverable. Project manager has a proactive and guiding role in this section. In this process, parts are built, plans are executed, code is created, and houses are constructed. Keep everyone focused on completing the work to the project charter and management plan. This is the responsibility of the project manager. Focus on preventing problems rather than just dealing with them as they arise. So most importantly, once we have done a proper planning and we have done a detailed planning, so we will see, don't see too much change request coming from the customers, from the clients, if we plan the project properly. Make sure all team members have the skills, information and equipment needed to complete their tasks, their roles. In monitoring and controlling, in this process, our execution deliverables are measured, what we have completed. Then we will go to our quality department will inspect, review, compare and verify and monitor and reported what the variance they have seen and how we can forecast for the remaining of the work. This is the main theme of monitoring and controlling. In this process, results are taken from execution and you are used to compare them against the plan. If there is a difference between the plan and the result, corrective action is taken either to change the plan or to change the way in which it is being executed in order to ensure that the work results line up with the plan. This process is about influencing about future results, forecasting, and not so much about fixing past mistakes. This process recommends changes include defect repair, preventive and corrective actions. Lastly, we have a closing section, process group. Closing efforts includes administrative activities such as collecting and finalizing all the paperwork needed to complete the project and technical work to confirm that the final product of the project is acceptable. It can verify and document the project or project phase meets completion or exit criteria set in place during project planning. Create and distribute a final report of project or phase performance and create lesson learned for the upcoming projects. And most importantly, evaluate the customer satisfaction regarding the project and the deliverables. If the customer is happy, we have a chance that we can get more projects, more business in the future. And most importantly, we have a very higher reputation in the market if the customer is satisfied with us. Lastly, we will hand over the completed deliverables to the appropriate stakeholders, to the customer or operations department once the deliverable or our project objectives are completed. Now I will discuss about the exam requirements. A 4-year bachelor degree, and number two, we have 3 years of project management experience with 4,500 hours leading and directing projects and 35 hours of project management education. Number two, or secondary diploma, high school or the global equivalent. Basically, we need 5 years of project management experience with 7,500 hours leading and directing projects and 35 hours of project management education. This 35 hours of project management education, I can provide this one because I am a PMP certified and I have a good experience of Middle East and I have worked on different international projects. And even in Pakistan, I'm worked on a project which is accomplished by a Norwegian company. In exam, there are different types of questions. It can include multiple choice questions with 4 options. And you have to select only one right answer. There may be a question, even one or more than one paragraph with a lot of details, strange and weird question. Maybe a simple, they will ask a simple definition. So these are a club of complex questions and simple questions. Exam may ask for a straightforward question with no tricks. And there are 20 or 25 questions which are used for future reference. Grading is not done on these 20 questions. Basically, exam comprises of 200 questions and our marking is based on 175 or 180 questions. These 20 questions, we don't know which are these one, which will be used for future reference. Lastly, I have a conclusion. Demand for skilled project managers can continue to raise. Because in every field, development is going on and every client or customer is looking to produce their deliverables in a smart and an efficient way without losing too much money. And they are doing the cost benefit analysis where they get the most benefit. So they will look for the more benefits instead of cost. So after passing this exam, skilled individuals have a proof of foundation knowledge needed to manage projects successfully from beginning to end. The advantages, benefits of PMP certification are the mere glimpses. Its effective utilization will surely we have much more benefits. This is my conclusion on the importance and the advantages of project management to get this certification. If anybody has questions, he can ask me about that one. Huh. Anybody have any question related to this?
Sir, training ya certification ke liye educational level kis ka hona chahiye? Like bachelor's complete hona chahiye?
Dekhiye, maine aapko pehle bataya ki agar aapne bachelor's kiya hua hai, uske baad aapka 5 years, 3 years ka experience hona chahiye projects ka. और अगर आपने डिप्लोमा किया हुआ है या सेकेंडरी डिप्लोमा जिसको कहते हैं डिप्लोमा किया हुआ है उसके बाद आपका 5 years का एक्सपीरियंस होना चाहिए।
बट सर ट्रेनिंग जो है ट्रेनिंग विदाउट एक्सपीरियंस हो सकती है।
सॉरी
ट्रेनिंग के लिए
ट्रेनिंग के लिए एक्सपीरियंस रिक्वायर्ड नहीं है और आई थिंक इसकी जो ट्रेनिंग के बाद आप 2 साल तक एलिजिबल हैं एग्जाम देने के लिए पीएमपी का।
ओके सर थैंक यू।
थैंक यू। एनीबडी हैव एनी मोर क्वेश्चन?
हेलो अस्सलाम वालेकुम।
वालेकुम सलाम।
लेट मी फर्स्ट इंट्रोड्यूस I have done earlier MBA finance and then I have some working experience and the for the last 10 years I'm running a school and in the last 2 years I did my master in education planning and management.
Okay.
In education planning and management I have studied project management. So agar main chahu ki main apna career project management mein start karna chahu तो क्या है ये मतलब मेरा अभी वर्क एक्सपीरियंस और क्वालिफिकेशन ये है।
देखें प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट अब देखें जो भी चीज नई बन रही है डेवलपमेंट जहाँ पे भी हो रही है प्रोजेक्ट तो अब वर्ल्ड वाइड चल रहे हैं और इसका स्कोप तो काफी हाई है आजकल चल रहा है तो इसमें
okay,
तो
मैं अब ओके वन मोर थिंग मैंने जो आपकी वेबसाइट जब सर्च की थी मैं एक्चुअली सॉरी मैंने अपने जो अर्लियर मेरा एक्सपीरियंस था उसमें मैंने ISO 9001 की हमारे ऑफिस में सर्टिफिकेशन हो रही थी तो मैंने उसकी 15 डेज की ट्रेनिंग भी ली थी APO से जो जापान की थी और बांग्लादेश में हुई थी।
ओके
बस फिर मैंने अपना कैरियर थोड़ा स्विच किया है स्कूल में आई अब मैं दोबारा उसमें जाना चाह रही हूँ ISO में।
ओके बट प्रोजेक्ट की तरफ जाना चाहती हैं आप दोबारा?
ट्रेनिंग भी है एक्सपीरियंस भी है प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट की अभी एजुकेशन भी है तो इसमें अगर आप मुझे गाइड करें।
आई थिंक जो प्रोजेक्ट से जो रिलेटेड ISO की जो सर्टिफिकेशन है ना वो ज्यादातर आई थिंक वो ऑपरेशन से ज्यादा रिलेटेड है। What ISO says that whatever you are doing or what are you are saying, you are also practically implementing also these things.
Yes, बिल्कुल ISO यही कहता है तो उसके लिए जब organizations को अपनी certification करवानी पड़ती है तो उस certification का एक process होता है उसके बाद एक audit का process होता है internal audits auditors होते हैं और एक lead auditors होते हैं। मैं कुछ इन एरियाज को एक्सप्लोर कर रही थी कि अगर मैं इनको मैं करूं यहां पर अब स्टार्ट करूं।
सही देखें ये तो आपकी अपनी वो चॉइस है कि आप किस चीज में एक्सेल करना चाहती हैं किस चीज में बिकॉज ये तो बड़ी डायनामिक सी चीज है ना कि 5 उंगलियां आपकी बराबर नहीं है जिस चीज में आप फील कंफर्टेबल करती हैं या जिस एनवायरमेंट में आप काम कर रही हैं ये तो अपने बारे में आप खुद बेहतर वो कर सकती हैं। देखिए प्रोजेक्ट्स में ये होता है कि न्यू एडवांसमेंट या इमर्जिंग चेंजेस जो आ रही हैं आजकल ग्लोबली इनमें आपको ना सीखने का ज्यादा मौका मिलता है। मैं ये नहीं कहूंगा कि ऑपरेशंस में आपको सीखने का मौका नहीं मिलता लेकिन वहां पे जो ग्रोथ है ना वो थोड़ा स्लो होती है क्योंकि वो कंटिन्यूसली या असेंबली पॉइंट्स होते हैं वो डिलीवरिंग द सेम प्रोडक्ट या सेम उनका वो होता है। लेकिन प्रोजेक्ट्स में ये होता है कि आपको डे टू डे नेट नए डेली की बेसिस पे नए नए चैलेंजेस आपको फेस करने पड़ते हैं तो यहाँ पे एक्सेल और ग्रोथ करने के चांसेस ज्यादा होते हैं। दिस इज माय पर्सनल ओपिनियन।
ओके थैंक यू सो मच। थैंक यू।
किसी और का कोई क्वेश्चन तो नहीं है?
नो सर।
चलें ठीक है जी आप लोग अपनों का ख्याल रखें कोई भी क्वेश्चन हो। जी जी
एक्सक्यूज मी सर लास्ट स्लाइड ऑन कर दीजिएगा। ये वाली जिसमें कॉन्टेक्ट नंबर है सर। ओके थैंक यू फॉर अटेंडिंग अवर वर्कशॉप। इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी प्लीज कॉन्टेक्ट अस ऑन दीज नंबर्स ऑन योर विजिट अवर वेबसाइट। थैंक यू।
ओके अल्लाह हाफिज।
Love this.